Greetings. This has been a tough video to complete, but after 3 rewrites, this is what I'm calling done. Basic human needs are pretty well understood. Food, shelter, and others are on the list. Well, more formally in something called Maslow's hierarchy of needs. One missing concept, however, is that of control. Humans are unique in our obsession with the future and anticipating or preparing for our future comfort. Though there are some examples in God's creation of planning for the future, we know there are examples from the animal kingdom that indicate an instinct for planning. Proverbs 6:6, "Go to the ant, O sluggard, consider her ways and be wise." I'm pretty sure ants do not qualify as examples of planning in the animal kingdom. But squirrels gather nuts for the winter. I have no doubt a squirrel is an animal. People, on the other hand, were created in the image of God, and I believe we have a desire for control that is godlike. The challenge is, right now is not like any previous time in human history. Many previous egomaniacs and narcissists have thought they could conquer the world. The Antichrist will come very, very close. And I think it will be very, very soon we see him rushed to power, not decades away. The Bible foretells of scenarios that imply economic collapse. Revelation 6:5, "And when he opened the third seal, I heard the third living creature saying, 'Come,' and I looked, and behold, a black horse, and one sitting on it having a pair of scales in his hand." The scales imply the economic exchange of goods and currency. How do we know that? The next verse. As always, context, context, context. "And I heard what seemed to be a voice in the midst of the four living creatures saying, 'A quart of wheat for a denarius, and 3 quarts of barley for a denarius, and do not harm the oil and wine.'" This could mean currency devaluation, or resource scarcity, or a combination of both. I think we already see an example in Venezuela, a socialist dictatorship. Some of the richest oil reserves on earth, and the people starve because the state has no regard for them. Statism and socialism do not emulate or implement Christian charity. Don't be deceived by those who say they do. Revelation 13:16, "And the second beast required all people, small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on their right hand or on their forehead, so that no one could buy or sell unless he had the mark, the name of the beast, or the number of its name." The Antichrist will establish economic control where he can. And I think the Left Behind series performed a disservice to Christians. It popularized the notion a small band of rebels, renegades, would jet-set around the world, untouchable by the Antichrist. Super preppers, da-da-da-da! If only we could set up this top secret secure phone network before the collapse. If only we could buy these radar invisible Gulfstream jets so we could hopscotch the globe. If only we had the resources and planning to set up global black markets to trade food off the grid. Let's use a cryptocurrency like Bitcoin. Yeah, that's the ticket. We have got to ask ourselves, why? An honest answer must include the desire for preservation of this life, in some measure, if not entirety. Well, if you do not believe that a rapture will occur, it seems the only logical pursuit, right? You must survive to the end to fight in God's army at Armageddon against the Antichrist. I've said before, I was raised to, quote, be an overcomer, quote, in the stream of Christianity I grew up in. And that is a problem with only learning part or half of the scriptures. But that is a different topic for a different video series. Revelation 2:10. Do not fear what you are about to suffer. Look, the devil is about to throw some of you into prison to test you, and you will suffer tribulation for 10 days. Be faithful even unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. We read this verse, see the word tribulation, and immediately think the tribulation. But where then does the 10 days come into play? Suffer tribulation for 10 days. Don't try and torture a meaning for 10 days just to convince yourself this is the tribulation. Instead, let's take a look at the context. Revelation 2:8, to the angel of the church in Smyrna write, these are the words of the first and the last who died and returned to life. The first and the last is the Alpha and Omega. The Alpha and Omega is God. So this is God speaking. God, who died and then returned to life. John 16:12. I still have much to tell you, but you cannot yet bear to hear it. However, when the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. For he will not speak of his own, but he will speak what he hears, and he will declare to you what is to come. What has the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, taught us they could not bear to hear? God himself had come to the earth to die as a sacrifice for our sins. Jesus, Yeshua, is God. I know your affliction, same Greek word translated tribulation, and your poverty, though you are rich. And I am aware of the slander of those who falsely claim to be Jews, but are in fact a synagogue of Satan. This does not say all Jews are the synagogue of Satan. If you want to be accurate, this refers to those who falsely claim to be Jews. But I will not go further down that rabbit hole in this video. Do not fear what you are about to suffer. Look, the devil is about to throw some of you into prison to test you, and you will suffer tribulation for 10 days. Be faithful even unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. We read this and think, hang on, until you are killed, and you receive this crown. Survivalist and prepper planning is in fact logically consistent with a plan to get that crown. But in my heart, I am concerned, because this has a self-centered motivation. I believe we should be thinking of the harvest. We must never forget about the harvest that God desires. John 4:34, Jesus explained, my food is to do the will of him who sent me and to finish his work. Do you not say there are still 4 months until the harvest? I tell you, lift up your eyes and look at the fields, for they are ripe for harvest. Already the reaper draws his wages and gathers a crop for eternal life, so that the sower and the reaper may rejoice together. Do not confuse the grim reaper figure in a black hooded cloak with reaping a soul saved from destruction. For in this case, the saying, one sows and another reaps, is true. I sent you to reap what you have not worked for. Others have done the hard work, and now you have taken up their labor. This is a team effort for Team God. This is all to fulfill God's desire that all men might be saved. Sure, some will choose to go to hell with Muhammad. But we must not play God and deny the truth from those who have not heard it. But I'll run into yahoos and hateful people, Texas. won't lie to you. Yes, you will. Matthew 13:24. Jesus presented another parable to them. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and slipped away. Understanding parables requires discernment, or you'll draw the wrong conclusion. But while everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and slipped away. Logically, one might observe the weeds are in the same field as the wheat, not in another different field. If they were, who would care? Does the same field mean in the church? I don't think so, but one cannot rule that out. When the wheat sprouted and bore grain, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, "Sir, didn't you sow good seed in your field? Where then did the weeds come from?" "An enemy did this," he replied. So the servants asked him, "Do you want us to go and pull them up?" "No," he said. "If you pull the weeds now, you might uproot the wheat with them." Has God allowed the weeds in the earth so that pulling the weeds did not hurt his people? Or has God allowed the weeds in the church so that pulling the weeds did not hurt his people? I've struggled to find any hint one way or the other. Let both grow together until the harvest. At the proper time, I will tell the harvesters, first collect the weeds and tie them in bundles to be burned, then gather the wheat into my barn. And this is where reading into the text may just get you into trouble. My point in reading this is referencing the presence of the weeds until the harvest. But if your bias is anti-rapture, you may glean the rapture is the removal of the weeds. I think the theme we must focus on is the harvest. Sharing the truth must be our number one priority. You will run into weeds that call you racist and Islamophobe and other insults. But sharing the truth is laying up treasure in heaven where thieves cannot steal it. So where are you laying up your treasure? Where do you think you can possibly preserve wealth that they cannot steal? Cash on hand? In your mattress? It will be devalued and replaced with a new currency, more traceable. You have perhaps one alternative, yourself, your mind. However, realize that even that will be taken from you when you will not bow to Islam. Islam will take your knowledge when it takes your head from your body, or when you will not bow to the strong delusion. Because that is also a blunt instrument the Antichrist will soon use to further attack Christians. If you will not bow when an insane person demands you use their momentary pronoun, I hesitate to say pronoun because a noun is just so static and objectifying. Maybe it wants to be an action verb. It is coming. The insanity resulting from the strong delusion is beginning to swirl all around us. So where is your heart? Does your heart cling to the truth? Is your heart longing for the Lord, for the bridegroom? Is your heart touched for the lost, who every day get closer to the flames? The insanity is even now claiming that words are acts of violence, and if some one thing feels aggressed, they are excused to react and attack violently. You are watching the last glimmer of the light of logic slowly die on the horizon. We are approaching that night Jesus spoke of when no one may work. John 9:4, while it is daytime, we must do the work of him who sent me. Night is coming when no one can work. I know of only one hope that can be offered to humanity. The good news, the gospel of the salvation of redemption by the crucifixion of the Lord Jesus Christ. And soon this will not even be an option for those who will not receive the love of the truth. It only gets more interesting from here. And if you think you can save this life, that you can fight with physical force and stop the invasion of Islam, you have not fully understood the reality and the times you now live in. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.